Good morning, everyone. Today we will discuss the best tricks to learn alloys. As we know, it is very difficult to learn the composition of all alloys, so we can use many tricks so that you can easily learn all the alloys composition. Okay, so first it is written here, brass. So how you can learn it? By using this word, Pitaji. P means pital, that is brass. Ta means tamba. G means zinc. So ta means tamba, it is copper, and G for zinc. So you can learn easily. It is made up of copper and zinc, and it is used in making utensils. Bronze. Now our next composition, it is bronze, that is made up of copper and tin. So tin, it is having a symbol Sn, but how we can learn it? By using the term cousin. So you can learn Cu means copper, Sn means tin. So next term we have German silver. So how you can learn that? We can use the word Nikkuzi. Nikkuzi. Okay, you are giving the respect to Nikku by using the word Z, because it came from German. So that's why we can learn Ni means nickel, G means zinc, and Ku means copper. Okay. Now next term we have duralumin. Duralumin means, you can learn by this way, means it is having a more duration. That's why we are using a four composition, in that aluminium, copper, magnesium and manganese. But how you will learn it? By, you can learn man ko mange alu ko. Okay, so you can learn by using this trick, duralumin. Now next term, it is magna aluminium. In this word you can see here, it is made up of magnesium and aluminium. Okay, it is made up of magnesium and aluminium. But how you will learn this term, solder? Actually this word is solder, but if you will use soldier, soldier, they are doing the fighting only by leta, late kar wo karte. So solder means leta. So leta you can use for lead, leta, le for lead, and ta for tin. Okay, so by using all these tricks we can learn very easily all the composition of alloys. Thank you.